question. What does that say about you and me?
I know. Great minds think alike. I was so thinking about that too. It's funny. We've had many conversations of favorite TV shows and whatnot. So.
Just the good old boys.
You know, this roundabout, hopefully here in Troy, would not have any of that activity going on there. That was wild. You know, how about that volcano, right? It looks like a Christmas town here in Troy. I'm not mad at it. I love the fact that Troy still has these decorations up, even right on through February. Have at it. This is great. I just can hear the Christmas music playing, and too much is February Christmas music going away. We got the snow still sticking around there. I think that snow will have a chance to melt this weekend. Temperatures get above freezing tomorrow, well above freezing on Sunday, where we get into the 40s. And if it's still trying to hang on, certainly going to melt early next week, where we get into the upper 40s and lower 50s, and even get some rain to kind of help it melt as we get into the day on Tuesday. We'll talk about that in a second. First, though, ooh, it is cold. 7 degrees is the wind chill in Wilmington. 4 degrees in Dayton. Kettering coming in at about a 9-degree reading. 14 degrees in Springfield because the winds are backed off, only a 3-mile-per-hour wind. And then calm in Greenville, and we're sitting right at 5 degrees, so pretty cold there. So overnight tonight, and first thing in the morning, too, just really going to be chilly. Temperatures in the lower teens, and with a slight little breeze, it might feel just a little bit colder. But nonetheless, we are looking at really cold temperatures first thing in the morning. So if you have to walk the dog, you're headed out to work early in the morning, really bundle up. Now, these temperatures here, where we're looking at Denver at 45, Dallas at 43, these temperatures are going to slowly migrate eastward. So second half of the weekend, going to look pretty good. Early part of next week, we're talking about looking at these warmer temperatures in the 40s and 50s. Then as we get into the mid to latter part of next week, that's when the temperatures go back down to seasonable levels. We have a dry weekend, and it's about time. We haven't seen that in forever. Now, there is one little system that will come in Saturday night that will give maybe the northern areas of the Miami Valley a few flying flurries. That's it. Nothing to write home about. But the daylight hours, going to be dry, going to be marvelous because the temperatures are warming up, so not going to be overarchingly cold. Here's our next chance for rain. Comes in Monday. This model is bringing it just a smidge earlier than before, about 5 o'clock or so. So it could be a wet commute home on Monday afternoon and Monday evening, but Monday morning's commute going to be just fine. But Tuesday morning's commute, we're going to have some showers that are going to be around. And then that gets out of here by Tuesday night, and we bring some colder air in here behind the front. Ahead of that front, we're talking about lower 50s for the day on Tuesday. So overnight tonight, 11 degrees, partly cloudy, cold, and on the calmer side. Get you into the weekend, it's looking pretty good, 37 tomorrow. The clouds will be on the increase tomorrow afternoon, so we'll call it partly cloudy through the day tomorrow. But at least the temperatures are right where they should be. 41 by the time we head into the day on Sunday. Partly cloudy skies there, so looking pretty good. And then we'll get even warmer as we get into next week. 48 degrees for us on Monday. We get a few showers again that come in the evening time, so the clouds are on the increase. 52 degrees by the time we head into the day on Tuesday, but it comes at a cost. We got breezy conditions. It's showery out there. And then for Wednesday and even into Thursday, partly cloudy skies, much cooler. Old man winter is back. 33 degrees for Thursday. We could have, a model was saying we could have a few flurries around for Thursday. So let's just kind of keep that in the back of your head. Nothing's going to accumulate, though, but just a chance for a few flurries there. Okay, Judy Redimbo sending us this shot of the full moon from the Miami Valley. Thank you, Judy, for sending us this shot. Beautiful picture there. And then Paulette Rediger sending us this one as well from the Miami Valley. Beautiful shot. Thank you, Paulette, for sending us that. Of course, Jesse Mag will be here in the morning to keep you up to date.
Thank you, sir. After a disappointing loss to the University of Illinois Chicago last